scripture that I had to use. Mm-hmm. But when I heard you read the scripture, and I sat there, and I looked, and I said, Lord, I'm going to use part of this scripture. I'm not going to use it as a scripture to help doing. Yes. And what he said, because what he said is a blessing.
Yes.
I'm going to use the scripture differently to show how wonderful obedience can be. And I'm just going to use the two last verses in the scripture that was read. I'm going to ask Sister Blanche to read the two last verses of the 15 and 16. Bless them.
And the boy spake unto him again the second time, what God has cleansed, that who knows thou from on. This was done thrice, and the vessel received up again in heaven. Yes.
God bless him. God bless you. God bless the saints. Praise God. Listen with your ears and understand with your heart. And no preacher that stands to ridicule or to overturn anyone. His duty is to minister as he hears.
Yes.
Now I'm not teaching. I'm preaching.
Yeah.
Preaching is different from teaching.
Yeah.
I love to hear Pastor Scott teach. Let us praise God. Because I don't read as much as he read. Mm-hmm. You sit and read, and sometimes when I hear him say something, I sit quietly. And if he starts to ask me something about that, I can't follow him.
Right.
But it's one thing I know, that God gave every one of us according to our ability.
Amen.
Let us praise God.
Amen.
And whatever ability God gave you, that is what you must use. Let us praise Him. Praise His name. Praise His name. Praise His name. And don't be afraid to use that. Oh, hallelujah. Listen, somebody think that sweeping the church is not an ability. Well, you know, somebody, I miss somebody here today.
Yes.
I know I miss somebody. Sister Vanda.
Yes.
Yeah. She just came to me, you know?
Yes.
But brethren, Sister Valda and her and Sister Clark and those who sweep the floor, that's a great ability.
Yes.
Because some people can't sweep good.
That's right.
Yeah. We have a whole saying that we used to say, Pastor Scott. New broom.
Sweep
clean.
Yes.
For the whole room, not the closet.
Amen.
You can't beat the whole room. Cannot be the whole head, but no room to clean.
Yeah.
So David said in one scripture, I would rather to be a doorkeeper in the house of God. And if you do that with all your heart, everyone come in your home, the door, God bless you. God keep you. You know? And if the sweeper sweep on the floor and they say, glory to God. Oh, hallelujah. It gives you joy to your heart.
Yeah.
But today we're looking at a man whose name is Peter, one of the 12 apostles that were trained by Jesus Christ. He is a Jew and he's not a Gentile. So Jesus came and trained 12 men. Now they could not minister until when Jesus ascended back to heaven.
That's right.
He sent them out one time to minister to Israel. And he said to them, go not into the way of the Gentiles, not in the way of the Samaritans, but go to the lost sheep of Israel. Because you see, anywhere they go and preach, Jesus has to follow up after. Let us praise God. For while he was teaching them, at that time, they had no Holy Ghost. They couldn't even understand. Let us praise God. The moment they really understood, way down in St. John 16, when Jesus was coming to the place nowhere, he had to be offered up. The disciples said, Lord, speak no more in parables, for now we believe that God did send you. And Jesus prayed for them in St. John 17. Because in St. John 18, there was going to Samaritan heart. Where he is better than the Gentile. For brethren, there's only one nation that is Jew.
Yeah.
And that's those that came out of the line of Abraham.
Yeah.
There's no other nation under heaven that is a Jew, but those that came out of the line of Abraham. Let us praise God.
Yeah.
And they never become a Jew until when God bless Jacob and changed his name from Jacob to Israel. Let us praise God. Then they become a nation of people. Those are God's exclusive people. You can't beat them. And now, although they are in backsliding, don't trouble them. If you can't keep in the box, you say so. Let us praise God. No nation under heaven that can beat these people. Even though they're in backsliding, don't touch them. For God must come back for them. Out of them must be taken 144,000 virgin Jews. For God promised Abraham that they are his everlasting portion. God will never forget them.
God.
But here was Peter, blessed by God. He left and he went to spend some time with Peter.
Peter.
But here was God now about to bless the Gentiles according to his promise that he promised Abraham, that in him all families of the earth will be blessed. And while Abraham finished and blessed them, we understand that Peter was now ready not only to preach to the circumcision, but he must now preach to the Gentiles. And brethren and friends, Peter is the preacher. Let us praise God. This church can only have one preacher. Let us praise God. Let us praise God. I said one preacher, one leader. Let us praise God. And all, everybody must come under him. Obedience is better than sacrifice.
Amen.
So God was about to save Cornelius. So God, now that Peter was proud, still had the Jewish ways in him. So God had to remind Peter by the sixth hour when he was gone to pray. The Bible said he was hungry. And while he was hungry, he would have eaten. But it was time to pray. It was the sixth hour. He must not pray, but while he was praying, he was hungry.
Yes.
And the Bible said he would have eaten. Why not appearing?
Yes.
Hey, God said, you know something? I'm going to teach Peter a lesson.
Yes.
I'm going to remind him. And God, while he was praying, God let Peter go into a trance.
Yes.
It's like a dream.
Yes.
Now listen, the Jews don't eat any and anything. That was given to them by the law of God through Moses. And there's something that we eat at Gentile. That they're not eating it. And when God blessed them, God told them certain fish, certain birds, help me. And you know, that they must eat. And anything that don't want it, they don't want it. So they're special people.
Yes.
They mustn't eat fish without skin.
Yeah.
You know, we like mackerel.
Yes.
But mackerel has scavengers.
Yes.
Mackerel eat anything. Every man, everybody. But God choose them and tell them what to eat. Because they must keep themselves clean. For out of them must come the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
They don't know. sleep with his father's wife.
Yes.
And Abraham said, you will not excel with them. And he blessed all of them. When he looked at two of them, they were wicked. He blessed all the one of them who come to Levi and Simeon. He said, oh, hallelujah. He said, you are instrument of cruelty. But go on. When he come to Judah, he blessed him. And he said, the scepter shall not depart from Judah, nor a lawkeeper come between his feet until he shall come. So somebody was all the fool.
Yes.
But thank God. When he bring the sheep down and put it before Peter. You know Peter don't eat nothing. So after no showing. That God is now going to cleanse the Gentiles.
Right.
And they're going to call them common. Now they're clean. No matter who are, praise God.
Yes.
No matter who come into the church,
yes.
Praise God. Don't you have to receive them?
Yes.
Yes, especially if them believe.
Yes.
It doesn't matter if there's a prostitute or whatever they are. And you see them come into the church, receive them.
Yes.
Don't look on them.
Yes.
Don't look at them anyway.
Oh,
because I said pray.
Yes.
But as God said, you want to see people come into the church.
Brethren,
you have to have unity.
Yes.
One spirit.
Yes.
Yeah? And when you do that, when you're one, you see people marching in.
Yes.
Coming in one by one. So obedience is better than anything you can do. So when God speak to Peter, he was at the house of Simon a Tanner. And God specifically speak to Cornelius and told Cornelius was not a Jew.
No.
Cornelius is a Gentile. But Cornelius get to love God, and he was kind to the Jew. Oh, praise God. There's a thing in the Bible that says if you do good, good will follow you. And if you do evil, it will follow you too. Let us praise God. It's best to do good. Praise God. Praise. And Cornelius was doing good to the Jews. But Cornelius now get to love the Jewish religion. And the Bible said that Cornelius stopped to pray. God do not answer the prayer of a sinner. Can I get some amen?
Amen.
God do not answer the prayer of a sinner. Let us praise God. Let us praise His name. Let us praise His name. God will not. The sinner can pray. I said you can't pray. But when you don't, when you pray, you must have somebody to take your prayer to God. Let us praise God. Let us praise God.
But
when the pastor prays, take the prayer to God, God will hear you. Let us praise God. And after you praise God. Then, so Cornelius prayed his prayer, come up to God as a memorial. Did you think I'm lying? Remember the Phoenician woman went to Jesus? I said, Lord, my daughter is grievously healed with a devil.
Yes.
What did Jesus say to her? You come to see about her soul. What did Jesus say to her? Jesus said to her, it is not meet to give the children's bread to the dog. Gentiles were dogs, sister. We do all kind of things. Even to this day, that's what he wasn't insulting her.
No.
He was just showing her that what he bring first must be for the children. And while she came and asking him to heal her daughter, he said to her, it is not meet, put it where you are, it is not right to give the children bread. It was not time to give it to the Gentiles. Praise God. But this Gentile lady asked, oh God, she was so sweet. She never took it as an insult. She humbled herself. And she said, Lord, even the dog in the crumbs that fall from the master's table. And Jesus looked at her and said, woman, hallelujah! Hallelujah! No. Jesus looked at her and then he beheld the faith that was in her. He said, woman, be that to you. I have not seen such faith in Israel. Glory to God. brought to him. Oh, hallelujah. And then Cornelius obeyed. And the Bible said that Cornelius got two of his servants that was in the house and sent them according to what the angel told him. Never changed nothing.
No.
Brethren, as Pastor Scott said today, any minister change. God, Jesus Christ said in scripture, anybody have a takeaway from that book, God will have to them the place that are written in here. Let us praise God. So Cornelius sent the man to Jeffa with exactly the same words that was given to him by the angel. When he reached Peter's house, Peter was praying. So God wanted him to understand that it's now time for the cleansing of the Gentiles. So what God did, God put him in a trance, let down the sheet from heaven, you know. There's nothing unclean in heaven.
Oh,
anything comes from heaven clean.
Yes. Right.
Anything up in heaven clean.
Oh,
the angels clean everything.
Yes.
And there's no night up there, you know.
No.
There's no night in heaven.
No.
It's one glorious
day.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Go back beat them to go back. But why?